Grand National of all time. 44 riders, 43 losers, but one man was going to ride the winner. And what a surprise. This was the weather. What a day. These were the losers. And these were the winners. Bob each way punters, hundreds of on-the-nose backers. Well, it just wasn't their day. If only they'd known. Somewhere there was Foinavon. No form, no chance, they said. 100-1 winner. Even Curtle Lad must have been more in the running. But it was Foinavon with the biggest odds for 20 years that was to be first home. And on they went into the second sensational circuit. None of them could know that a couple of minutes ahead, they'd be involved in the most incredible pile-up of all time. Running into Beecher's, two loose horses were first over. But this was where the fantastic full stop to the Grand National began. No callers, everyone safe over. Ahead, a simple gorse fest. But it was not to be. Pop them down, a first jump faller really popped them down. Different class, the Fosser, Lime King, Norther, Dunwoody, all went down. Watch the incredible pileup. Out of the shambles, one horse appeared, complete with rider, Foinavon. But at the 23rd, it was chaos. Horses were going in all directions. Some of them back the way they'd just come. Some jumped, some just clambered over. Somehow, most of the runners got going again. But a long way ahead was Foinavon. Jockey John Buckingham could hardly believe his luck. Over the canal turn, and he was more than 200 yards ahead of the field. Nobody could hope to catch him. But there were some triers. Honey End wasn't going to let him get away with it too easily. Foinavon safely into and over Valentine's. Only a fall could keep him from being first. What a day for the bookies! This was the last fence between Foinavon and the £17,000 victory. Honey End had closed the gap, but not nearly enough. Foinavon, tired, slowing, but unbeatable, ran for home. That was the win that made it bookies' boom day and shattered the hopes of thousands. In the winner's enclosure, no owner, no trainers. Neither could be at Aintree to greet the winner of the Grand National 1967. Never in a million years did they expect a win. There he was, the best of the bunch. No wonder he was all steamed up.